All right.
Students, this is the pre-recorded voice of your pre-recorded principal, Dr. Principal Boros.
I kind of want to, at least briefly anyways, explain why there wasn't a stream yesterday. And that's just because I went to quote unquote a party. It really wasn't a party, it was just me and three other co-workers just hanging out. And I normally don't do stuff like that. Yeah, I talk to people and such, but I don't normally go hang out with people like that. So I just want to, just because it's just something that
has been eliminated.
At least other people anyways think that I should do more of. But it's not just that though. The real reason why is just because of The two of the co-workers I was hanging out with are going to be going back to school. They're college students, and they go to school out of the city. You know, some The schools they go to, right, the colleges they go to are outside of the city that I live in right now. So they're not going to be working with me for much longer. And, I was just trying to be a bro and drink some beers with them. And just chill one last time before they go. And I don't think that they won't ever come back. It's just that, you know, I myself have been a college student. And two semesters will take up at least 9 months in total. Because each semester is about 4.5 months long. So it'll be about a year before I get to see these guys again. But at the same time though, I'll be doing something else. Continuing search for fugitive. Next year. And I probably won't be working next April. So I'll be in the same boat soon enough. Hate these enemies. Oh man. So annoying, they just push you around, deal so much damage. There's no break, there's no like amount of time in between their attacks where they're not damaging you. They just straight up keep attacking you over and over again without any pause, without any break. And you can't do anything about it besides just whack them back. Hope that you end up, not dying. I didn't even quick save throughout the entire time I did that. Take some of this stuff. Yeah, not only did I want to do something special for them, I just wanted to do something special for myself as well.
Attention students, this is the pre-recorded voice of your pre-recorded...
I probably won't be doing stuff like that very often, and it'll interfere with my streaming schedule. I really don't have a streaming schedule, it's just literally whatever I get back from work every day. Or almost every day, I should say. Something else was on my mind. I was taking a look at Corone. Can you tell I'm not Japanese? Corones and Botans, or Botans, however you pronounce it. Recent streams, and both of them are playing competitive games. No, sorry. Ronnie wasn't. She was playing SpongeBob Battle for Bikini Bottom. Be hydrated. And I'm not sure if she plans on speedrunning the game, but when I looked at that video of hers, or I mean stream of hers, it just reminded me of speedrunners that, you know, obviously speedrun the original Battle for Bikini Bottom game. And Botan was playing Guilty Gear Strive in her recent stream. It got me thinking about this idea. I'm not sure if I'd be willing to play competitive games
engaging hostile target
during my streams, or streaming myself rather, playing competitive games. I mean, I've tried to do it in the past with speedrunning Psychonauts, but it got to the point where I just got tired of not having fun, you know, playing Psychonauts that way, that eventually I just kind of had to stop.
Please take cover until the danger has been eliminated.
One of my favorite games of all time, you know, just kept making me mad more and more as I kept playing through it over and over again, trying to get PBs. And it just wasn't worth it. I was not posting my best times on speedrun.com. I wasn't really doing anything with the Discord group. Even though I did join the Discord group for Psychonauts, speedrunning Psychonauts. And while I was wanting to learn the advanced stuff, and I was doing it for a while, the advanced tricks and glitches and exploits in the game, there was one in particular that just got me stumped on how to do it properly, and after failing to do so many times, I realized that, wait a minute, this is a frame perfect skip, right? If this is frame perfect, now I understand why speedrunners hate doing frame perfect skips, tricks and glitches and stuff like that. It's so difficult, even if you pull off correctly. It's so difficult to pull it off consistently. Unless, of course, you're doing a tool-assisted run. But yeah, these two Night Stalkers just literally spawned at the other end of the hallway. That's dumb. I also hate the fact that Night Stalkers don't really have anything worth taking. Both in caps and in utility. Okay. So yeah, I eventually just thought to myself, you know what, if I'm not enjoying speedrunning Psychonauts, maybe it's not the game itself, right, that I'm speedrunning. Maybe it's not Psychonauts that's making me not enjoy speedrunning. Maybe it's just speedrunning in itself that's just not enjoyable for me. Maybe I just really do not like speedrunning games in general. And when I thought of that, I just kind of quit. You know, I'll be blunt. I did just, you know, quit speedrunning altogether. Sometime later, we're talking like maybe earlier this year. It was definitely earlier this year, but probably like 2, maybe 3 months ago. I was trying to get back into playing League of Legends, especially competitively, just because I've always played casually and almost nothing but normal games. And I wanted to play competitively just to see how far I could go in the rank ladder. whether or not I could make it to Diamond. But just like with speedrunning Psychonauts, it eventually got to the point where I realized, hey, I am not having fun doing this. I do not really think that it's worth playing this game, right? For the sake of getting a few measly points out of like so many matches. And more times than not, because it's a team-based game that constantly changes without the player's input, by the way, players don't really, even the best ones don't get a say in what does and doesn't get changed. Because it changes so much, and there's always more stuff to learn because of that. It's just so frustrating and stressful to just learn to play the game. Not even play the game well, just learn to play well. That I just got fed up with playing the game altogether. Because I realized that there's just no way I can control the game, or have as much control in the game as I do in this one, Fallout New Vegas. Yeah, I get it, as they're two vastly different games, right? You know, League of Legends is multiplayer, New Vegas is single player, but it will get a multiplayer mod soon. League of Legends is also a competitive game that consists of matches with the same gameplay loops over and over again. Whereas with New Vegas, there's still the same gameplay loop. Realistically speaking, all I'm doing in every build and playthrough of New Vegas is grinding out XP through various means, min-maxing skill points, special stats, and so on, and trying to conserve and obtain resources as many resources as possible. So in that respect, they do have that in common. Yeah, they just have addicting gameplay loops, but you know, they just vastly differ in many other ways. Are you kidding me? You know what? I'm getting tired of... Hold on. Let me look up exactly what I'm supposed to do with this quest. I'm not going through that... That area test again. I'm not doing it. I just don't care. Should then proceed to the X8 Research Center and go through the main quest line for this area until they reach the residential test facility portion of the quest. After activating the residential test. What residential test? Where is that? I don't know what residential test it's talking about. I don't understand. Yeah, basically that's all I had to do was just... Okay. I'm not sure if that was part of another quest, but whatever. Yeah, that's all I had to do. DNA agent perk granted or study the bonus. Damage bonus. It's not stalkers. Nice. Okay, I can close this out now. Oh, I'll leave it open. Anyways, back to League of Legends and competitive gaming in general. I was just not having fun with the game, so just like with speedrunning Psychonauts, I quit. Also, apparently my power... Oh, yeah, that's dangerously low. Yeah, we can fix that real quick. What? You've got to be kidding me. Well, that's no bueno. Alright, then. Never mind. That sucks. I keep losing my train of thought because I keep focusing on the game and while trying to talk. I've had this problem with my drawing streams as well. But anyways. I quit playing League and my curiosity towards the rank at which I can, you know, obtain just kind of faded. I just didn't care anymore. Because I thought to myself, even if I do get to Diamond or above, is that really worth all this? Is that really worth losing my sanity over? What? That's another thing too I don't understand. Sometimes the explosive damage doesn't register. Should not have to have wasted that many mines. Oh, that's it. Okay, that's all I had to do. Wait. No, yeah, it's still going to blow up. Nice.
We are in trouble. That didn't rhyme.
Two, as in too late.
As in always as one. I hope it's glowing up right now in your faces.
Yeah, kind of. But after looking at a Botan's recent stream of Guilty Gear Strive, and not just hers, but as well as a few other streamers and content creators that play fighting games for the majority of their content. Not to say that I want to go back to fighting games, but it does make me wonder why I just don't care for competitive games in general. And whether I would go back to playing competitive games. Because if I do, I'm more than likely going to stream myself playing competitive games. Yeah, whether it be fighting games, MOBAs, whatever. I just don't believe that I'll be as easy to listen to. If I did, then I am right now by playing something that's not going to make me angry. But there's no other way to explain it. Like, I don't like losing, nobody does, and I would probably sound a lot like Desbug, a YouTuber that plays Super Mario Maker. If I were to stream myself playing competitive games. So, we'll see. The thing is though, once I start playing competitive games and such, it becomes a huge time sink, and it's more of a commitment. The more I play, the better I would get at the game. But the less I play, that also works in reverse. The less skilled I become at the game, just from not playing the game enough, in order to learn the game. Learn how to play the game better.
Prepare to be attacked by Dr. Mobius!
He's not gonna touch that.
I see you now.
I just don't get it. Sometimes the explosives just don't do any damage at all. The reason I think I favor casual games a lot more now, I appreciate them a lot more, just because of that one thing I explained earlier about competitive games. I would have to be committed to playing competitive games religiously in order to, of course, to learn how to play better and thus, you know, get better at the game. But when it comes to casual games like this, that's not as much of a priority, just because the game is not designed in a way where the enemies and obstacles in the game are supposed to be as evenly powerful as the player's character. Typically in single player games, the player and whatever, you know, because of whatever protagonist they're playing as, will have some sort of advantage over the enemies and obstacles in the game. A good example of that would be the Max Payne series. Max Payne, of course, is able to use bullet time and thus slow down time for the player to be able to aim better and avoid gunfire, or avoid, you know, taking in as much bullets as possible. In competitive games, that's not really a thing. Yes, technically speaking, all players that are playing a competitive game match will have some sort of advantage over the other, but it's supposed to be balanced, you know, I'm using air quotes here, balance, so that the advantages that all the players have are equal in their effectiveness. So then it doesn't really become an advantage at that point. You're not going to have one player be able to do something that's going to allow them to have a higher chance of winning over the other players in an ideal world, right, where the competitive games they're playing are completely and utterly balanced so that no players have any kind of huge advantage over the others. I know Sucker's attacking that Robo Scorpion.
Rant. See how I abstract my rage, think tank? I hold you in such disdain, I generalize my hatred for you!
That ain't something you normally see. I'm just gonna let them fight it out. While I, you know, sip on some sarsaparilla. So going back to what I was saying earlier, my point is that it's hard to appreciate being good at a game when literally everything is just as powerful as you are. It's just as dangerous as you are. See what I mean? Like, if that Cyberdog was somehow designed to be able to have just as much health and deal as much damage as my player character, then I wouldn't really enjoy the game all that much, now would I? Because then I would have to fight many, many more of those throughout the entire time I'm in Big Mountain. And that's not to say that I want the game to be easy. I don't. I mean, I play the game on very hard right now, and I do plan on playing it on hardcore eventually. But even on very hard, and even on hardcore, the game is still designed in a way to allow the player to... To be able to overcome these challenges without having to sacrifice every single one of their healing items, AP or mana in the case of League of Legends, cooldowns, etc., etc. You don't have to blow your whole load just to take down one enemy in New Vegas. You can if you want to, but there's just no reason to do so if you're playing the game smartly. There's also another thing that I really appreciate about casual games versus, or I shouldn't say casual, more like single player games versus competitive games. Competitive games typically tend to be multiplayer based, but speedrunning exists, so yeah, that doesn't necessarily mean that all competitive gaming has to involve multiplayer games. But I digress. With single player games, I can stop and start whenever I want to. There's not going to be a match I'm stuck in.
Do not approach the pylons.
Where?
Pylons are the glowing things.
Okay, what
also,
is this?
Do not approach a fallen pylon. If you see a fallen pylon, call security.
I got dudes like these just chucking grenades at me. And I'm having to fight against an army of robo dogs. At the same time, die. Don't mind if I do. Come on, let me out. Okay. That's worth some caps, but not enough to take it. You know what? Forget it. That's probably because... No? Never mind. I'm not going to be stuck in a match, and depending on the game itself, right? I'm not gonna be stuck in a match for...
I'm not enjoying this.
Yeah, me neither, dude. I'm not gonna be stuck in a match that lasts as long as somewhere between 3 to 45 minutes. Well, actually, 3 to 5 minutes for fighting games, and 15 to 45 minutes for MOBAs. There's none of that happening, right? If I don't want to play the game, if I'm playing and if I'm playing a single player game, I can just literally stop whenever I want to. You know, that's, there's nothing, there's no punishment for literally quitting in the middle of a fight in a single player game such as this one. But in multiplayer based competitive games, of course there are, and even even single player based competitive games like speedrunning, of course, when it comes to speedrunning, if I decide that I just don't want to continue a run, then I gotta start the run all the way over the next time I want to, attempt a PB. I can't just, pause the timer and pause the game and then just not, play for that game for a while. I mean, I technically could, but of course, if I try to submit it to speedruns.com or, go on to a live demo of a speedrun on, say, GameZone Quick, they're not going to allow me to do that. That's dumb. No one's going to want to see that. And it would just waste everyone's time on top of that. So, in that respect, I enjoy single player and casual games, non-competitive gaming, just because of that alone. I have so many of these, I really don't care. I should honestly just restock up the scene.
Hello, sir. I'm afraid I'm a very lethal killing machine.
So am I, dude. So am I. I don't have enough people following me on any of my social media, but especially my Twitch channel, to bother asking whether or not, my followers would want me to stream myself playing competitive games. So in that respect, I am lucky to be able to just do whatever I want right now. Just because there's not going to be any fans, subscribers, followers, etc. telling me, hey, I really like you making this kind of content, so therefore I'll watch more of your stuff. If you make more of this content, I'll, like more of those videos, I'll, post more comments, etc., etc. I don't have any of that going on with me right now, so I can literally just stream whatever I want. I don't even have an obligation to stream New Vegas. I just do, just for the sake of consistency. I don't want to just go through the... I don't want to go through the trouble of changing the title of my streams every single time I don't want to play New Vegas. So it's just less work for me to do it this way. Think of that what you will, but when I get off of work, right, when I clock out of my shift, I don't really enjoy doing more work on top of that, especially since I go to the gym even after my shift is over. I like to relax, you know, sometime during the day. During the day. Anyways, my whole, like, discussion on competitive games and streaming competitive games. The whole point of me talking about that stuff is I'm still not sure whether or not I want to stream myself playing competitive games or not. I don't know. We'll see. I just don't have the drive to go through not only the grind, but also the drama. Not necessarily like getting into arguments with other people or something like that, but the drama of, you know, losing really badly and having, you know, that feeling of being a complete failure, right? After devoting so much time and resources into doing something I want to get better at, as well as the drama of getting like a euphoric high from winning a really difficult match. A match that, you know, seemed like defeat was guaranteed to happen.
Try this intercom thing. It makes you sound like some kind of sky god.
This is in the location. There's something else that I was going to talk about. I literally just thought of it, but I just forgot now. All that grinding paid off. You gonna let me level up? No? I don't see why not. There are no enemies around. Not even on my compass. Alright, thank you. Might as well raise this up 100. I already know that I got all the skip books for survival. What else was I gonna talk about? It must have not been important if I just forgot about it. Yeah, I really need to get my armor repaired. I'm taking way too much damage just from gunshots alone. I was talking about drama. I remember that. of how badly it feels to lose and how great it feels to win. Oh, right. Yeah, I was talking about how I just don't have the drive, the motivation to compete anymore. And I think that that may be because of the fact that I'm just older now. I just don't care as much about stuff like that. And I physically do not have the energy or the patience to play competitive games. So it's just like an endless horde of enemies. I literally cannot just stop and talk for a few seconds. There's always like some enemy coming at me. He's dealing extra damage to me just because of that proton axe. Proton axes deal extra damage to enemies in power armor. In this case, I'm wearing power armor.
What terrors does a big mountain hold for the intrepid seeker? Really? Does anyone know? I'm at a loss.
Nice. Apparently I didn't save after I leveled up. I'm just gonna go ahead and go back to the sink for now, while I got the chance. Yeah, I just don't have the drive to just invest a lot of time and energy and resources into just getting better at a game. Just one game. Even if it's the most popular game in the world, I don't know. There would have to be a lot of perks to streaming myself playing such a game in order to convince me. Because I'm way past the point of doing something just because it's fun. Unless, of course, you know, it really is fun. But when it comes to competitive gaming, competitive games are only fun when people win. That's it. Winning is just fun. Losing competitive games is not fun. I don't know anyone that will legitimately think that. That's just not logical.
Might I be of service, sir? Very good, sir.
It just costs too much. Does he have...
Might I be of service, sir?
Does he have some metal armor?
Very good, sir.
My bad.
Might I be of service, sir? Very good, sir. Should sir be in the market for a new suit of morning wear, I have several suggestions that might suit.
No, just combat armor. Oh, that's too bad. I'm gonna have no way to bring it back either. Sucks. No, that's it. Like, I literally have no way to repair it now. Okay.
Might I be of service, sir? Very good, sir.
I need more of those. That. I really need to get some water. Me, 1 second. I definitely need more of these. How many do I even have? I should have, like, almost none now. Been spamming them so much. Yeah, that's not a surprise at all. Like I said, I'm not profiting from killing a lot of these enemies, so I find it pointless to fight them at all. If I didn't waste my time going through that test area over and over again, you know, I wouldn't be in this situation right now. Oh, that sucks. Really sell that.
Might I be of service, sir? Very good.
Alright, cool. That, I'll take those. If I'm going to be playing something, or just doing something in general that I don't want to do, that I don't have to do, I better be getting something out of it besides just, you know, bragging rights or something. I don't feel that way about New Vegas just because, as I've already explained in the past, I've said this so many times now, I've already played this game a few times recently, like even before I started this playthrough with this build. And I did it off stream. So of course I'm going to play this and stream myself playing this, even if literally no one watches me. You know, I, of course, do appreciate anyone that does watch my streams, especially when I'm streaming this game, but nevertheless, though, I don't have any motivation. I don't need an external motivation, an extra reason to play New Vegas. I'll just play it anyways, just because I genuinely do enjoy this game. I can't say the same thing about competitive games, or speedrunning, for that matter. I don't want to hate the games that I enjoy playing just because I'm just trying to play them a few seconds faster. I just don't want to be in that situation. Some people are willing to do that, me, no. Oh, totally forgot to make more impacts, I think. Maybe not. About to do something. I completely forgot. Oh yeah, that's right. Check. I don't really have anything else that's gonna heal me besides stim packs. Sucks. I am not gonna walk all the way over there. I'm not doing that. I didn't discover it, you... Okay. Oh, I'm right at the hour mark, okay. I may just stop here then. We'll see. Oh, actually... No, this is Higgs Village, right? Oh, yeah, X-Ray Research Center. Let me grab that combat armor then, just so I can have armor that's going to not, you know, break. Not there. It was... Yes, over this way. Yeah, it was. Okay. And I'll climb up here. Thing is, though, I can't get up there. I don't think I need to. I did drop the armor here. One of these cages. Check. There it is, yeah. I think I dropped it up here. But maybe that was... Please don't make me have to go through all that again. Well, maybe I could just jump up there. No, I did. I did drop it there. But I can't get inside the cage. That doesn't matter. No, I just refuse. I'm not going through all that again. What's the, let me check. What's the console command? Oops, I muted myself this entire time. Yeah, I just was not willing to go through all that again. That, area. Test area, whatever it's called. Not doing that. Still surprised I can't just jury rig. By using this armor, that's weird. Of course I can do it with the helmet, for some reason, but not the power armor. Alright, whatever. Yeah, that's a no-no. Let me do this. That. I'll fast travel back to the think tank. Go to the sink, and then put it in a chest there. I just realized that throughout this stream, I've been just talking a lot. But because I didn't stream yesterday. I guess that's fine. Let me level up. Gotta wait. Gotta wait for the menu to pop up. Sometime today, please. Not gonna let me level up. Thank you. Let me go ahead and save it here too. Please let me just fast travel. No! Yes. So crouching. I was crippled for a second. I was like, why am I moving so slow? Alright, so what I'm gonna do is find. Actually, yeah, this refrigerator will do. I don't remember all this stuff being here. I guess it resets. That's probably a bad idea then to play. Put it there. Put it here then. No. Oh, combat helmet does need to be repaired. Okay. Or, you know, power helmet, I should say. I'll just wear this stuff though.
Primary. I might vibrate at a soothing frequency.
There we go. Cool. And yeah, since it's past an hour mark, I should stop here then. Go ahead and put this on. I'm mostly just thinking about the future of this channel. Do I become a variety streamer? Do I just solely play one game And that's just literally all I do. Do I get into competitive games? Do I not? I'll definitely be playing Minecraft. I've said that before. When the new update gets released. And of course, after I get done with this playthrough, which should be soon, just because I've already done a lot in Old World Blues. There's only Lonesome Road left, and then just literally the rest of the vanilla game I haven't gone to yet. Which shouldn't be much. I'll get the recent streams I've done for the past week. Upload onto my YouTube. I just gotta remember to combine that little segment of stream, what, 31, 35? I mean, stream 31, I think, of this game. The one where I didn't have the video settings at the correct resolution, so I had to end the stream and then restart it after I changed the resolution. I have to put that together in a shortcut and then upload it. There's also the possibility of me streaming myself coding as well, because I'm still in the process of doing that. I'm nearly done with that tutorial series that I've been following lately. Just gotta finish literally the last four videos. Not much more to it than that. Finish up the other tutorial series I didn't finish in the past, which aren't much. And then just test myself on what I've learned by creating my own game. And yeah, I think I'll try doing that future as well. So maybe I will be a variety streamer. I'll be doing drawing streams on top of all that. So yeah, I definitely just do not want to limit myself on what my content is, like I tried to do in the past. I was self-proclaiming myself as a speedrunner of Psychonauts, a professional artist, and a bodybuilder. I mean, I still bodybuild. I do that. I definitely don't speedrun Psychonauts anymore. As far as being an artist, like, I'm done with that. The only times I will be drawing at all now are literally only for the sake of making content, as well as finishing up any recent previous projects I started in the past. But that's it. Like, I'm done with being an artist. It's short-lived, quite honestly. I was an art student for 3.5 years, and literally after I graduated the studio art program, I only made my own digital art outside of school for like a year, and that's it. And it's not even much. I mean, I check on my DeviantArt and my portfolio is pretty small on that account. Or my gallery, I should say. It's just a gallery. But nevertheless, too, I just don't care for it. I don't care what kind of talent I have, or even if I do have the talent for it. I don't get anything out of it. And I definitely don't enjoy doing it, so I just don't see any point in me doing it at all. So, that. I think that pretty much boils down my future streaming possibilities or possible options for content to stream. Right, just literally anything that either gets me more views and followers and or just things I would normally do off stream that I just, you know, simply enjoy doing anyways. Yeah, I'm just gonna stop. I've just been doing that. I've been doing my best to just not make myself do stuff that I just don't want to do. Especially if I don't have to do it. Anyways, this stream's been going nearly 20 minutes longer than it should have, so I'm gonna go ahead and end the stream now. Peace.